Hi, this is Subramanian Jairam Subbu. I'm Oracle EP's Cloud SCM Manufacturing Functional Consultant. Today we are going to talk about Oracle Cloud Manufacturing Repair and Rework Process. So what is mean by repair and rework process? For example, if any customer, they bought the engines, or they bought the trucks, they bought the new car, or they bought any new laptops or tabs, right? So after a few days, they had to go for repair and rework process. Repair means they have to replace some parts in this, the drained ones, and they have to put in the new ones. If you talk that way, I have taken the diesel engine in my process. For example, I have a diesel engine, FG code. In that one, there is some core parts and dirty cores. Dirty cores are nothing but the drained ones, and remove the drained ones and put in the new one. And then adding some packing materials after completing this repair. And the same example, if you see in the car company, for example, I bought a car, like CR-V Honda 2019 model. And after 6 months or 1 year, I have taken my car into the service. And the service people, they did the diagnostics and they told that, hey, the battery was drained. So you have to replace that battery. I told, yes, please go ahead. And then here is the battery is nothing but the core part, the new battery. And the old battery, which are already drained in my car, is called like a 30 core. What they will do means they will put the finish code like car or engine in that work order. And they, when they're doing the operations, first they'll tear down that car or engine. Tear down is nothing but they go for a pull that 30 core part out. And then they will go into the assembly operation. They will put this new battery, and then they'll go for a testing, and then once the testing is done, and they'll go for a packing with the special materials or cleaning that car, and they will send to the customers. So this is a complete operation process which we are doing it today in a repair and rework process. This is the repair process mainly. If we talk about the rework, it's more or less same as a repair. The only the difference is when at the time of doing the manufacturing process, if any, instead of 0.03 the decimal points, diagonal hole, if you want to put it in that particular place, instead of that, something it got not exactly came in that way, like placing a hole or grinding or welding something. And then what they'll do means they'll keep it that part, that particular operation completion into the rework, and they will continue the remaining process. And then later, they will try to put that particular component, whatever there in my rework location, they will pull that component, they will try to, again, some welding and grinding something, they will make it possible that they repair it, and they'll put it in the completion subunit to go for the customers. That's the rework. More or less both the process same, but slightly different. This is the process which we are going to see in the system. But in EBS, we have only one process called standard non-standard jobs. But in cloud, if it come into the cloud, we have a different way we can see that. Go into this supply chain execution and go for the work executions. So we go in the work executions, manage work orders. When at the time of creating a manage work orders, you have something called in the down, there is a plus symbol. If you have any work orders, you can query that work orders. If you're going to create a new work orders, new jobs, yes, you can go here. You can see standard work order is nothing but the discrete job. This is a non-standard work order, is non-standard job in EBS. And rework work order, transform work order, both are slightly different to compare in the EBS. We don't have any this type of naming there in EBS. We have all called like a non-standard work order, standard work orders. This all, again, these two options also comes under non-standard work orders. The transform work order we're going to see a little bit later is like transforming from version, the lower version to higher version, or higher version to lower version. Mainly it's a lower version to higher version. We're going to see that later sometime. First, we'll concentrate the rework and non-standard jobs now, okay? So just click the rework work order. Once you click the rework work order, show more. And you can give the work order number. If you want to give a one work order number, you can give it. or if you are not giving, then the system will take automatically from the plant parameters. So just I'll give my own work order. 002 is my inventory or plant, and then I'll give some rework 1001. This is my work order number. So I'll note down somewhere here. I'll put it here, right? And then I'll give this item S21 diesel engine. This is my FG finish code, which I'm going to do the rework or repair. So this is my finished code part. And then how many quantity I go for one quantity. And then is unreleased, keep it as it is. And if you have any description, if you want to give, you can give your description here. And the supply subcenter where you are supplying from the, again, like stores. And then here is the place. If you have already predefined standard work definition, it's like a routing in EBS terminology. If you have already existing routing or work definition, you can keep it. Then automatically the system will take it from there. Or if you don't know, when you want to go for a different process for this particular engine to repair, and then you can remove it, you can do that. First, we'll go for a existing work definition, and next operation will go for a non-work definition process. Okay. Click save and edit. Once you click save and edit, this all operation 10, 20, 30, 40, which all came from my work definition, existing work definition, right? The 10 is engine tear down. And then after tear down, it means I'm removing this component, the T core part equal to -1 from my engine. First, I'm removing my T core like a drained battery from my engine or car. And then I am putting in the new engine, new core part in the engine or car, and then I'm going to test drive, and then I'll pack it and hand over to the customer. I mean, packing, I'm putting in the computer subinventory, and then the sales department, they will take care about there whether they want to pick and ship, or they want to give to the cash customers in the counter, or they want to call the customer and pick it up. This is the process, right? So once you're done, go to general information. This is my work order number. S2100 R001 rework 1001, and it's an unreleased status. And click and save, continue. And you can see here, this is my unreleased 1001. This is all the existing one already I created previously. So this is in process. This is not yet started. Not started. This is already in progress. So if you want, for example, the production scheduler. So if any multiple jobs, like 50 jobs, 100 jobs in his work area, if you want to take a control for that, if you want to take one step process, like all jobs you want to release or all jobs you want to go for a put a hold, or you want to cancel or close, you can change the priorities. We'll talk about more in the another video, how the production scheduler will do the priority of the jobs. For example, which job they want to take a priority. We have some priority rules. We can write that priority rules. Based on the priority rule, system will populate which job need to be released first. So we'll work on this more about in later some other session, like it's like a production scheduling, right? So you can select multiple jobs. For example, he has two jobs, you can select two jobs like this, or if you have one job you want to release, you can select the job, you can go and pick the release. Or you can go and release the pick materials. For example, single step, you can release the job and you can print the pick slip report, and you will go into the warehouse, you'll pick the material, put it in the shop floor for the manufacturing or repair. So let me release it. Once you release, the job is released. This is my job number. Now, once it get released, open this job and go for this history. And you can see here when it got released, and if you see the transaction history, and just job is released. In this job, this is the engine, my finish code, the material is issued. This is the first operation. When you go in the material transaction, you can see here the production transaction history. Now I want to perform the operations. First, I want to tear down. I want to remove my dirty core part or the drain battery. Go to review dispatch list. This is the place where you're going to do. So once you go for review dispatch list, and you can go with multiple search criteria. If you know the work order, you can go with work order. Or if you know your assembly area, right, work area, then you go for work area and you just select search. Whatever the work orders in my work area, it will display all the work orders. And this is my operation R001001 is my work order, right? So let me go and pull one day my work order instead of getting confusion to multiple ones. So I'll put the work order here and click search. So you'll get one work order, right? So manual reporting is, if you have any components or push components, right? And then you, it will show here, you can issue the material directly. Click here, it will allow you to push the materials if you have any push components. I'll show you that next operation how to do that. So click here and complete with details. Go next. And I see here -1. It means I'm taking off my 30 core part number, like a drain battery, out from my engine, my assembly, or finished good. I'm putting it into my warehouse, putting it in a subinventory. So where you want to put it? So if you want to put some different location, like I want to put in something like a quarantine some. So I want to create something called like a core subinventory. I can place all my core parts there, and later I can sell all the core to my suppliers. I mean, because the supplier will buy all the cores, and they'll reprocess it. They'll use it. Not the customer, suppliers. We are selling the core, 30 cores back to the customer. I mean the suppliers, not the customers. So -1, -1 is nothing but is a negative issue. So if you see in EBS terminology, it's called like a WIP negative issue. That is the transaction type when you're doing the material transaction, when you're doing in the WIP issue transaction, you're doing in the EBS terminology. But here we don't have something called like a different types. You need to select WIP negative, so WIP negative return. We don't have anything like here. The automated system will take care of that. So once you've done that, click next. And this is my resource transactions. Click save and submit. So here's the question. First, the user performed this transaction now, right? So you have completed the quantity 1 each and the operation 10, and the order is performed. The next operation is 20. Now you see the 20th operation came automatically. But after performing the 10th operation, the business user, whoever in the shop floor, he realized that he did a wrong transaction. So you want to revert back the transactions, how to do the reverse. This is the most common issues. Every time when you implement any product within the warranty support, 1 week or 2 weeks or 1 month, most of the issues will come like that, reverse transactions. The users normally, they will do the wrong transactions. They will request, hey, I did the wrong transaction. I want to reverse it, how to perform the reverse transaction. This is a common one. Everyone will see in the field real time. So if you want to do the reverse transaction, so I'll show you how to do that. First, let me show you that work orders. In this work orders, so history, go history, and then check the material transactions. You see here, let me re-query this work orders. So go here, work orders, search. This is my work order number 1001. I'll click this work order number. I'll go to the history, and I go to the transaction history. You see here, this is the first transaction material issue happened. And after that, the operation completed. Along with that 10th operation, this is a material negative issue, -1. This is a dirty core part we removed from the core and put it in that in my subinventory. And the resource got charged. This is the 5 hours resource got charged. This is the transaction. Now resource is pretty good. I don't have any problem in the charging 5 hours resource because they already worked 5 hours on this job, the resource. I want to keep as it is, but I want to reverse this 30 core. So I don't want to take that 30 core out. I want to keep it back in the engine. I want to get that approval from customer. Hey, shall I remove your drain battery, shall I put it in the new one? Or if you don't want, then I can keep as it is, right? So without a customer acceptance, I have done this by mistake. And then customer told, no, I don't want to use a new battery, keep as it is, the old one. I'll go for a different shop and I'll replace it. So I have to reverse my transaction. If you want to do the reverse transaction, there's something called like here, something report material transactions. If you want to reverse your material transaction, report material transaction. If you want to do the reverse your resource transaction, go and do the resource report resource transactions. Let me reverse the material first and then we'll see the resource, right? So go report material transactions. And what's my work order number? Some issue in this environment. Forget about that. So this is my work order number. And which operation you performed? I operation 10 I performed. Click next. Oops, there's some problem in this environment. All right, so application error. Let me go into the different browser, okay? So I'll pick this environment, go into this browser. S21M1 is my username. So I'm going to work definitions, work executions, and going to the report work material transactions. So I want to reverse my material transactions. Oops. So this is my work order. Operation 10. Next. Yeah, that's a browser issue. Here I can able to see that, okay. So here I'm not issuing, I'm doing the return. If you want to issue more material, yes, you can use them. You can use this issue transaction. If you want to do for a return transaction, if you want to reverse your issue transaction, yes, go for a return. And then this, I'm going for a materials manually entered. And I'll go for a S21 comp. Right, so here what is this, my previously issued -1, I'm giving -1 and just click and save. This is how you are going to do the reverse transaction. Click save and close. It's done. So now let me go in my different browser. So close most of the windows. Let me go and show you that my work order and my material transactions. Go here, manage, go into this supply chain execution, work execution. Go here. Manage work orders. I'll give my work order number. Search. So I'll open this work order. Go to operations. You can see this one not yet completed. This negative component not yet completed, and this resources completed. And this my material is a finished good is already issued in this operation. Go to history and see the transactions history. See the transaction history. The first time 8:40 p.m. it got completed 5 hours material 5 hours and one material got operation completed it got issued negative material, negative issue. You see here, after that, now 846, what has happened? Material negative return. So I have returned back this component to my finished good. It means reverse the component, reverse transactions. And the same way you can do the report material resource transaction also. If you want to reverse this 5 hours, you can do that. Again, what you can do means you go back again, dispatch, review dispatch. Again, you can perform these operations. Let me give this my work order. Here it is, yeah. Complete the details. Next. So, block post materials. So, again, you see it went for operation 20. Now, go back again. Back. So, so if you want to issue the material again back, if you want to perform the operation 10, what you need to do means you have to reverse this resource transaction and reverse this operations, and then you have to perform the operation 10 again. Right now in the this is in the operation 20. So I'm performing this operation 20. So just I'm putting in this core part. I'm doing my resource transactions. I'm completing and handovering to the customers. Right when it's got completed 20, it skipped 30 and it moved to 40. It means that already the 30th is my it's not a code point, it's an auto transact. It's a bottleneck operations. So I'll go for a quick complete. And then we can done. We have completed quantity one in the operation 10, 700 completed 708 mode, and it's a work order number. And do this. Close it. Go for the work order. Let me query that work order number. Search. So let's go for all now. Open this. You see, this work order is complete. So all operations are completed. And go for history. You can review the history. Transactions. You see all the transactions, whatever performed, resource transaction and material transaction, everything is performed. Once everything is done, then you can post this transaction from transfer transaction of production to costing is nothing but you are moving this transaction to costing. Then you are closing the work orders. So this is the one way you can do that if you have already predefined work definition. Right now I'm going to show you that without work definition how you can do that. There are many scenarios people create a work orders, non-standard work orders without any work definitions. So manage work orders and click here. I'll go for a rework. Show more. Take 1002. Go for this work order number. 21. I'll go for quantity one. Yeah. And my supply 700 stores where I'm going to supply for these parts. And then I'm going without work definition. I want to use this work definition. I don't need to use for this. So it's a very simple process. I'm click save and edit. Here is the business requirement is I take my car and I requested them, hey, remove this battery. And just remove this 30 core part, drained battery, and give it to me. That's it. And remaining, I will take care of it myself. Just remove it and put the new battery and give it to me. There's only two operations, right? So we don't want to use all the existing work. We don't have any existing work definition. Is a work definition contain the 40, 20, 30, 40, 50 operations? Yes, you can add that. You can remove it whenever you want. But if it is a one or two operations, normally people go and add it manually, right? So you can do that way. So go to operations, go to any operations. Click this plus symbol. And I want to add this operation. First is engine tear down. First, I want to tear down this engine, right? And then click OK. And then next operation I want to add, this material, a new part like assembly. I just want to add this assembly and then hand out to the customer. I'm not doing even test drive also. Right? These are the two operations I'm doing it. If you want to perform these two operations, what are the required? First, if I want to tear down my engine or a car, I want to remove my T-core part. Go ahead and edit operations items. Edit operation items and add this T-core part here. It's 21 comp. This is the part which I had it. And then this part requires not a push, operation pull. Right. So along with that, and customer requested add some other part also. If any fluids, liquids are drained or not, if not that, please add those two. Then I'll add another part number two. I'll add one more part. So click add. I'll give this part number here. And I will keep this operate supply type as push. So we have to manually push this component. So before starting these operations, these are the two components we have added, and I'm going to add a resource. How many hours resource going to perform these operations? It's already 5 hours, it's already added for this. Whenever we're adding this standard operation, automatically resource will get had. There is 5 hours, this resource. If you want, you can edit it. Sorry, this I had it in this assembly area, not in this teardown. I want to remove this. Let me go for items. So wrongly, I have put it in this operation 20. This should be operation 10. So I'll go for core part. So this is operation 20. I added core part in operation 10. I'm going to add 30 core and a liquid. Fluid looking. Go to items and add 21. This is like a operation full, and I had another component, something called like a fluid. This is the push component, push operation. Click OK. So here there are two components. One is 5 hours resource hours, and here's one component, and then 8 hours resource time. Then go to 7 plus. So here is coming, is a 1002, is unreleased. I'm going to release this job. The production scheduler see these jobs, what are the jobs are not released, and re-release the job, and it'll go for a technician. He will go and repair it. So now review to specialist, and he'll give this assembly area, this is my assembly area, and my work order number. Click search. This is my work order. You can see here there's something called like a manual reporting required. There's no tick symbol. If it is, there's no tick, it means that there is some parts are required, some push components are required. First, you can issue the push components here. Go and click this. You see, there's a material, fluid material we need issued manually. So this is a very easy way we can do that, but again in EBS, it's again, we have to do the material issue transaction. There you have to go and issue this push components. Click done. As you click done, 7 close. You see, the tick symbol came automatically. So here itself, when you're in the dispatch list itself, you can realize that what are the resources, push resources, or what are the resources, manual resources. If the resource type, the charge type is a manual, you have to manually issue the resource. How many hours? Go ahead and click complete details. Next. Yeah, I didn't put this component as some negative. That's the reason. But anyway, so you heard normally it should be negative component. And then next. Yes, it's not a negative transaction. We're not allowing any negative transactions back. And I have some components in my, I'll issue some component from my quarantine server entry. There I have some negative content is same close. So it came for operation 20. Go back again, operation 20. Quick complete. I'll go for a quick complete. It's done. It's got completed. Done. So you go here, go ahead and query this work order number and say here search. And here. All of business. See, completed. The job is completed. So this is very simple. There's another scenario. They're telling there's only one operation. I just want to remove my that echo part. In that case, what you can do means go here. Yep. Manage work orders. Go here. Rework orders. Show data some more. And I'll go for 3. One and my server entry is something called like stores. I'll release it from here. We don't have option here, release option. But normally EBS, when you're creating a web job, there it's a non-standard job, you can release it. But here we don't have option. Normally the production scheduler should have option to release that. And I don't want to use this my work definition. Save and edit. I'll go to the operations. Click here. I want to go for one of single step operations, just 21 tear down. Okay, go and add only my item. Yes, 21 comp. So here you have to give -1. If you want to take out the component from your engine or car, you have to give -1. So previous transaction, I just gave the +1, I forget it. Sorry about that. So now I'm doing another transaction, plus, and give operation pull. Click OK. I just add the resource. Resource is 5 was already added. So save and close. And query this work order number. This is my work order number, 1003. I'm going to release it. Once it get released, go back to dispatch list. It's very simple to compare EBS. There's no confusion on here. Everything is very simple. Click save, search. Sorry. Yep. So click here. You can see here, this time we're showing tick mark because we don't have any push components. Even you can click here, you can see is any push component. No, there's no push components. Now I'll go here, I'll click complete the details. There's only one operation, right? So go next. So I'm just issuing my, taking out my 30 core from my engine. Next, 5 hours. And once it's done, I'm putting in my completed subnet. So I'm close. So this is how the rework process will work, repair or rework will work. And then next session, we'll see how the transform will work. The transform work orders is nothing but upgrading the work orders. For example, I have one engine, 1.6 is there. So I already in market 2021, I released a new engine, 1.7, version 1.7. So I want to remove, add whatever the parts are required in that 1.6 version. I want to upgrade to 1.7. Or I want to remove, there are some processors I want to remove from 1.6 engine and add the new processors in 1.7 and release that as a 1.7 part. I mean the new engine, and put it in that sell to the customers. That is called like a transform process in cloud. But in EBS, we don't have that type of different classifications. And in cloud and EBS, we have just like non-standard job, you have to create, you have to process it. And here it's very clear, if you select the transform work order type, automatically it will ask what is the source part number, what is your destination part number, which part number to which part number you are going to convert. So those process we are going to see mostly the next session. Okay. If you have any questions, feel free, please reach out to me, subhuj1978@gmail.com. Or if you need any trainings, please connect with Nana, is the trainer who is giving cloud trainings at present. All right. Thank you, sir.